Morning show, and you know, guys, Carrie, people are excited for Christmas in July.
Yes, they are.
With Sweet 100, but there's another Christmas in July experience in Lopino and Paramin,
well,
apparently.
I know you love your Lopino, I really love your Paramin.
Yeah, those are two places, and add Matlot to that and a good.
Right, yes, you know, and they're very special places, yes. And they have such their own rich history, and you know,
which you're
really
going to find out about now.
Yes, I am going to find out about, so I'm looking forward to that. So I'm going to be chatting this morning with Antonio Tony Rodriguez, owner and director of Experience Local Limited. Welcome, good morning.
Good morning to everyone, and good morning to Trinidad and Tobago and the rest of the world.
Definitely.
How are you all this morning?
Fabulous.
I'm doing great, thank you. I like the energy I came with this morning. So tell us about your company, Experience Local.
Okay, so Experience Local, we are a locally based tourism company, and we are focused on three main elements: nature, cuisine, and culture. You know, and we target the local communities across Trinidad and Tobago because, I mean, there's so much to discover, so much to experience in Trinidad, not just Maracas Bay or Las Cuevas Bay.
That's,
you know,
right.
So we go to different communities, and although they are similar, each of them are unique, you know, and they have different attributes to contribute to our packages.
That's right.
So, yeah.
As I was just chatting with Lisa there, we were just speaking about Lopino and, you know, the rich culture there is there, and Paramin as well, you know, the rich culture that is there within those communities, and how they still hold on to that culture a lot. So tell us what you have planned this year for the experience, you know, of the Christmas in July, actually.
Okay. So actually, yesterday we had a Christmas in July in Paramin, and it was a whole day event. 8 hours, we started in the morning with a tour, and what we do, we try to incorporate the local stakeholders in each community, so everyone gets a piece of the pie.
Right.
So we will look for a native tour guide, someone who would do the transportation if the need arises, someone who would cook, and of course the entertainment. So yesterday we started at Chota Road Marvel, and then we took the ascent via Cameron, one of the many access points to Paramin, and then we went up on a plateau where we had breakfast. That breakfast included a sorrel, ham, zabuka, cheese paste, homemade bread, Paramin herb bread from Shodo Bakery. And we continued the scenic tour. So it was two parts. One was scenic and educational, and the other part was entertainment. And of course, we had Mr. Carlos, who is a well-known guy from the village. And he took us through the village up to the cave. There's a huge cave in Paramin as well.
Really?
And to the top. The summit, yeah. And the other part of the tour was the entertainment part, where we went by one of the residents who has an outdoor kitchen and patio which overlooks the sea in Paramin. You're going to see the north coast to the north, and of course the Marble Valley to the south. And we had a wide variety of lunch there. We had the Christmas rice, the pigeon peas, we got a taste of callaloo, we had pastels, a chicken, pork, a stew pork, Pancha creme, and of course, the best for last, some sweet Paramin music from the boys right there from the village.
Of course, I know. I missed a good time. I wish I knew about this before. I would have been there most present yesterday.
Well, actually, the demand is so high, we're actually going to have another event. We're going to do a repeat coming soon. Yes, very soon.
So that is good news.
So
that is very good
about
news.
2 weeks from now.
And, you know, considering things are a little bit different this year, of course, you would have had the event last year as well. Considering what we are going through, the worldwide pandemic, how has it changed the event this year?
Okay, so we launched our company this year, January. So we didn't have one last year. This is our first time, right? But due to the COVID-19 pandemic, you know, one of the major limitations, of course, is the numbers of people in the events. So we had the normal protocols where we had temperature tests, making sure that before we start event, everyone had a okay temperature,
right?
We encourage you to use our face masks on the event, but normally, because of the atmosphere and people singing and so forth, they can't really sing with a face mask, but we encourage that as well as the social distancing, you know,
to
the best of our ability right now.
Definitely.
So, yeah.
And you know, well, we'll have to chat with you again soon to find out, but where can we get more information about Experience and, you know, the upcoming events?
Okay, so we are on social media, all platforms on Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp. And on our pages, we have a list of events. We have each month different places that we go to. And as the month draw near, we send out the event and the description and the cost and everything. So it's out there.
All right, well, that sounds fantastic. I am definitely going to check you out on social media. And with that, I want to say thank you so much, Antonio. Tony Rodriguez, owner and director of Experience Local Limited.
Thank you very much.